Hello, this is Vampire, here to talk about the most ridiculous martial arts move that I see in Hollywood. I just watched a movie called Reborn. This is a Japanese action film, and it was amazing. I thought it was incredible. I really, really enjoyed it. But I was disappointed in one thing, and that was it had a lot of neck breaking, and to me that is the most ridiculous move that I see in a lot of movies, is the like that, and then they just fall dead, and it's like, I'm pretty sure, I've never done it, but I'm pretty sure in real life it's not that easy to do, you know. So the reason why I also say this is because back when I first enrolled into my first martial arts class that I took, the teacher was a Kuksuwan teacher, and one of his favorite moves was he'd walk up to you and he'd crank your neck. He'd go like that. So you'd go like that, and obviously never broke any one of our necks, right? So that was one of his favorite things to do. It was really annoying. It was really annoying to receive that. But he'd come up to you and go like that, and it would make the rest of our body follow the head, so we just flip, and so it was like a throw, a takedown, so that never happened. Now the other thing is, one time I was in a fight, and what I did was I grabbed the guy like this into a headlock, and I pulled him all the way down to my waist, and as I did that, my forearm must have caught him right here. So it turned his neck, and I remember hearing it go pop, 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 pop. And like on the fifth pop, I was ready to throw my entire weight into it, and I was going to put my hip into it, and really, like, I was already putting my whole body into it, but I was going to hit the ground to really go all the way. So my goal was to make this go past here, past the shoulder, to turn all the way over here, make him do the exorcist. So it's been pop, 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 pop. And then right at the last part where I was about to really crank it in, that's when I thought, dude, if you break his neck, won't he die? And that thought, that one thought made me freak out and stop. And I let go. I immediately like, whoa, what am I doing? I don't want to kill a guy. So I let go. And I remember he got up and he was like in severe pain, and he left. You know, he was holding his neck like way over here, and yeah, I mean, it looked really messed up, and the guy left, right? So what I'm trying to tell you guys is that I put a tremendous amount of effort to try to break his neck, and I still wasn't able to. Yeah, I stopped myself, but it took a lot of effort. It wasn't like that. It wasn't reaching from behind, grabbing the chin and snapping it like a spinning top, like a Beyblade. It doesn't break that easily. It's very, very difficult to do. Now, does that mean that the move is fake? No, I think the move is very, very effective, whether it's this move or you go up to them and you crank their, you know, do this to them. I think it's a very effective move in martial arts, and it's a legit move, but it's not the way it's portrayed in Hollywood. You don't do it to go and then he falls dead. That if you're expecting that, you're very unrealistic. But you do that, you go pop, and then you change it to something else, you know, or you use it as a follow-up, where you don't just expect instant death, then I don't see a problem with it at all. In fact, I think it can be very effective, you know. So it's just the way that it's portrayed. So anyway, that's it for now. Thank you for watching, and take care, folks.